Minister, last night you said that the current housing and homelessness crisis was a matter of concern. Now, I want to put it to you that it is not a matter of concern. It is an emergency. And the first step in resolving this crisis is for you to recognise that it is a crisis. In fact, it is a crisis that is now becoming an emergency. You also said last night that you inherited this problem from the Fianna Fáil government. That is absolutely true. They turned housing and property into a gambling casino for the banks and property developers, and that caused this crisis. But that's not the end of the story, because in the 3 years you have been into government, you have not addressed that problem, and the measures that you have taken have made the crisis worse. And you have to start to admit that fact. You have made it worse by cutting the rent allowance, which Joan Burton told us 2 years ago would lead to rents reducing. She was wrong. Admit it. It didn't work. It didn't reduce rents. Rents have gone up. You made it worse by abandoning the direct provision of social housing construction in your document that you referred to in June 2011 and said that you were primarily going to rely on the private sector and in leasing arrangements with the private sector. That has failed. The landlords are pulling out of RAS arrangements. They are pulling out of leasing arrangements because they can now make more money on the open market. So it's not going to work. We've even had the Mortgage Brokers Association representing landlords saying they will not solve the problem. So the people that you are looking to solve the problem are stating boldly they will not solve the problem. And furthermore, by giving a veto to the banks on mortgage distress allowing for the repossession of homes, we are facing another catastrophe, as those people will be put onto the housing list and made homeless because there is no social housing. So the first step on the road to wisdom, Minister, is to say it is not a matter of concern, it is an emergency. And in the gallery today, we have some of the human faces of that emergency. Bethany, 19, on a TOOS scheme, but homeless. Department of Social Protection are saying they're going to cut her off the TOOS scheme because she can't give an address. Because she can't give an address. Lindsay.
Deputy.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
The rules of the House are, as you know, that you should not name persons in the public gallery or outside the House.
That's not true.
I'm sorry, Deputy. It is true. I'm sorry.
It's been done before.
I'm sorry. It is.
Okay. Another family.
And the Deputy will address
another
the chair.
Another family. Okay. Don't cut into my time.
I'm sorry.
Another family.
I'm sorry, Deputy.
Okay.
I'm sorry. You will address the chair, and you will not name persons outside the House or in the public gallery. Otherwise you're out of order.
Yeah.
Otherwise you're out of order.
Yeah. Another family.
If the deputy wants to engage on that subject, I'll engage as well.
Another family.
Deputy.
I'm not naming them now. Just leave me alone.
For the last time.
Stop playing political games here.
For the last time, Deputy. For the last time. Show respect for the House. And remember, you're in the House of Parliament, not in some corner. So please address the chair.
You're cutting into my duty.
I'm going to leave the House because you're out of order. You're out of order, Deputy. You're out of order. You are out of order. I remind you.
Leave us.
You're out of order. You will leave the House. Allow the Deputy to continue.
Show respect for the independent.
You remain in order.
Leave
the House. Deputy, you want to continue?
Another family. Two people, mother and a father, and their sister, with 8 children and their grandmother in a 2-bedroom house. Nothing from the local authority. Another family in the gallery. 7 children on a month-to-month basis of getting a variation of the rent caps, but being told it won't last, and they're facing homelessness if the rent allowance policy is applied, the rent caps policy is applied. Another family in the gallery, 15 years on the list. Another family in the house. The receivers moving in on their landlord. They have people sitting outside their house
from the receivers intimidating them and don't know where they are going to go when they are put out. And another family, five children for the last 6 months over in a hotel in West Dublin when the kids go to school in Shankill. Another family, 14 years on the list. Two children in desperate wrath, chronically damp accommodation where their kids are sick as a result of the damp, and they are 14 years on the list, nothing being offered them. Another family with three children sharing one bed with their mother for the last 18 months, can't get a private accommodation because of the rent caps, and it goes on. I won't even continue through the list, it would be too long. That is the human reality, and it is replicated all over the country. So you have to face the fact that this is an emergency. And you say, well, we don't have the money to do what you are asking to do in terms of dealing with this crisis. I beg to differ, Minister. You are paying €500 million in rent subsidy to private landlords every year. €500 million would build 5,000 council houses. Okay, 5,000, and it would save money for the state. They would get extra rental revenue back. If you built, Father Peter McVerry has pointed out that the Newlands Cross, the changes of the traffic lights, where there's going to be €100 million spent on changing the traffic lights at Newlands Cross, that would build 1,000 houses at current market prices. This year, we are going to give €9 billion, to pay off the debts of bankers. Couldn't you say to Europe, we're holding back €1 billion? We're holding back €1 billion, we're going to build 10,000 council houses, and if you insist on paying them back, you can say we will make savings by spending that much every year for 5 years in terms of the €500 million we're spending on rent allowance going into landlords' pockets every year, so we can pay you back in 10 years' time. Even the European Investment Bank would accept the logic of that. So there are solutions if you are interested in doing it. But tragically, what I believe is happening, Minister, is that the real decisions are being made by Michael Noonan. He knows the banks are holding all this property. They want to inflate the value of that property in order to save their balance sheets. And so it suits them to have a housing crisis where rents are going up and rent and property prices are going up.
Thank you,
so yet again, the human beings and citizens
Thank
of
you,
this
Deputy.
Country are paying a terrible price
you
for the fact that it's the banks being put ahead
now.
Of human beings. So we are appealing
Thank
to you,
Deputy.
Minister. We are appealing to you. Start to build council houses. Guarantee
you,
that everybody will get a roof over their head within distance of where their kids go to school.
Thank you, Deputy.
Provide the emergency accommodation
your
that people need so that they are not homeless,
your
sleeping
time
in cars,
expired,
or sent to hostels in
Do
the other side of the city.
Do not ignore the chair, Deputy. Your time has expired. We now move on to put the question on.